17 years after its debut, Star Wars Galaxies remains one of the most ambitious MMOs ever created. I'm Dan, aka Wolf, and today we're going to take a look at the epic open-world sandbox known as SWG, Star Wars Galaxies. In short, if you've never played this game, SWG is Star Wars like you've never seen it before. Vast landscapes across dozens of worlds offer hundreds upon hundreds of square miles to explore. Head into the wilds and tame creatures and massive beasts. Hunt criminals and force sensitives as a notorious bounty hunter. Become a famous entertainer in Holostar, sought after by your community to headline events and offer powerful buffs to adventurers. Scour the galaxy for rare resources as a prospector with harvesters across lush and fertile worlds. Establish your merchant empire in a completely player-driven economy, where the best equipment and goods are player-made. Gather your friends and pioneer your own outpost on the galactic frontier. Work together to recruit citizens and grow your outpost into a thriving city. Lose yourself and the creativity and detail of decorating your own residence or establishment. All of this and more awaits you in that galaxy far, far away, as only SWG can deliver it. Even though SOE shut down their servers on that fateful day on December 15th, 2011, thanks to a team of enterprising coders, Star Wars Galaxies lives on through the SWGEmu project. This has spawned a slew of independent servers that have added their own code and customizations. In short, if you dig out your old discs or borrow the files from a friend, you can install the game, download the EMU client, and be playing on your chosen server in no time. For the sake of this video, we are playing on the highly recommended Empire in Flames server. Some of the features we will be discussing with you are exclusive to Empire in Flames and its sister server, Sunrunner 2, but this is, for the most part, SWG at its amazing and wonderful core. Star Wars Galaxies was one of the first MMOs to have an in-depth character creator. Most of the available races have a pretty wide level of detail you can give them, considering the age of the game. Your customizations can be further expanded by meeting with a player who is a master image designer, and they can offer you more hairstyles and more hair color options, as well as skin and fur pigmentation choices beyond what is available at creation. When creating your character on Empire in Flames, you can choose from 37 different races, including droids, Hutts, Keldor, and Nautilans. While most of these species and race types have pretty in-depth character customization options, some of the new ones added by EIF do only have a few, but that's okay, because SWG also has one of the most massive wardrobes available to characters right out of the gate. There's nothing hidden behind levels or grinding. Most clothing and armor options are immediately available and can be crafted by master tailors and master armorsmiths as soon as your character's boots hit the ground. This means that your character can get some of the highest quality armor at the very beginning of your character's journey, the cost of which is easily achievable by grinding some missions. Unlike most games, stat bonuses do not originate with equipment. Instead, they come from looting skill tapes and armor attachments that can be applied to equipment. Instead of a level system, SWG features a skill point system where you can spend points to go through skill trees to create a truly unique character. EIF takes this a bit further, allowing you to have one chosen profession that you get for free at no skill point cost. That means that you can be a bounty hunter, commando, doctor, entertainer, merchant, ranger, smuggler, or squad leader. You can augment your chosen profession by spending 250 points on various skill trees such as architect, artisan, armorsmith, bioengineer, carbineer, chef, creature handler, dancer, droid, engineer, fencer, image designer, medic, musician, pikeman, pistolier, rifleman, surveyor, swordsman, tailor, terrazkazi artist, and weaponsmith. Now, there are three basic character types that most, but not all, characters fall into. You have your combat characters, your crafters, and your entertainer characters. Though, a master entertainer, who is also a master dancer and a master musician, will still have 124 skill points to spend fleshing out their template. So yes, it is possible to have a completely fulfilling career and character journey in SWG without doing any combat at all. But these are only straight builds. You can absolutely mix and match to create unique characters. Want a smuggler who is also a master dancer? No problem. Want to be a commando who is also a master weaponsmith? You can have that too. Additionally, players who have established their own city can level the politician skill tree for free, not costing any skill points. On Empire in Flames, politicians affiliated with the New Republic can run in an election to become the senator of their planet, while politicians affiliated with the Imperial Remnant can run in an election to become the Imperial Counselor of their planet. Senators and counselors vote on which planet to attack in the ongoing Galactic Civil War that happens every 6 days on Empire in Flames, and while that is a video for another time, it should be noted that PvP on this server is on a voluntary basis only. SWG features perhaps the most in-depth crafting system of any MMO, the foundation for which lies in resources that span over a dozen worlds, with each planet offering its own minerals, chemicals, gases, flora, and fauna. The system randomly generates resources with a unique name and unique values to their stats, and these resources shift irregularly and have a random lifespan of 6 to 21 days in which they're available to be harvested in the game world. Crafters and prospectors are always on the hunt for the next valuable resource that spawns into the galaxy, where they will then track down, harvest, and hoard up their storerooms with. While there are items you can craft whose stats do not matter, such as furniture, structures, and a few other things, for most items, each step of the crafting process affects the final stats. Crafters can experiment in an attempt to create schematics with the best stats, stacking bonuses from their crafting tool, skill tapes, buff food, and being sure to perform their experiments in a player city that is a research center. Their schematics can then be uploaded into factories where they can mass produce up to 1,000 copies of the item, provided they have enough of the exact same resources that they used in creation of the schematic, which again plays back to resource lifespan and rarity. And the more complex the item is that you're crafting, often requires many manufactured subcomponents from multiple factory runs. Crafters can give unique names to anything they make, allowing you to put your signature brand on items. And any item that can be crafted or looted from the world can also be physically placed in a player's home or shop, lending itself to unique decorating opportunities. As a game within a game, some players build museums as they try to collect every rare item in the game. While there is a lot to love about SWG, it is not without its blemishes. As of this video, the game is almost 18 years old, and the graphics certainly look the part. While the game debuted a revolutionary terrain system in 2003, it was not efficient by any means. Even when playing on a modern PC, the bottleneck lies in the game client calculating the location and type of flora to place, which means speeding across a planet can often look like this. Fortunately, there are some mods you can install to extend draw distance, but they can be a bit tedious to deploy for your average gamer. Additionally, SWG is a very complex game that is notorious for its lack of handholding. If you're going to take a deep dive into everything that is possible in this massive sandbox, you're going to have to figure things out, research guides, and ask questions from your server's community, most of which are more than happy to help new players. In closing, this is just a quick peek at SWG that only scratches the surface of what the game encompasses. Until next time, may the Force be with you.